Way back in the ancient times of October 2023, the Bottles Project announced Bottles Next, a new chapter. Now, presumably, if you are here, you probably know what Bottles is. If you don't, basically, it's a convenient way to manage your wine prefixes for playing Windows games, running Windows software, things like that. Now, it's a little bit different to tools like Lutris, but they both serve the same general use case. Now, when the project first launched way back in 2017, it was a very, very different project. And when a project has been around for that long, there's gonna be some design choices you make which probably weren't the best of ideas, and eventually you're going to need some sort of restructuring to make sure things are maintainable long into the future. And the idea of Bottles Next was basically take the project, take all the lessons that have been learned over the lifetime of the project, and build it again from the ground up, making sure you're making the correct decisions from the start. And one of the major changes they wanted to make is the idea of the Next and the Classic mode. Now, Next was going to work very differently from the way it currently does. Next was going to basically be the easier way of working with Bottles. Rather than having wine prefixes for every single application you wanted to run, instead, there would be a singular wine prefix with all your software, all your games being run inside of, and then you would isolate dependencies and configurations through the use of a layering system. And Classic mode, as the name might suggest, is like the way it currently does, like it classically does, where each application you're running has its own individual wine prefixes, and this is more like the advanced mode of running Bottles, giving you a lot more control over how things are being configured. But as wine keeps getting better and better and better, there's less of a reason to put that advanced configuration first and foremost in front of the user. Along with this, the current UI was built long before the existence of the Steam Deck, long before anybody cared about running something like this on a handheld device with a small screen. So it needed a new UI specifically for use with the Steam Deck. Not to compromise the desktop use case, but an alternative UI for the Steam Deck. So it needed a new UI specifically made for things like the Steam Deck. Not to compromise the desktop UI, which also should be good, but something that makes sense on that smaller device, something that makes sense on a touchscreen, and something that makes sense with controller support. Along with this, splitting out the architecture to allow for more UIs to be made in the future, splitting it into a clear client server agent model, where the client is the graphical interface that the user interacts with the application with. The server is the core part of Bottles that is making sure all of the fun application stuff like fits together, and the agent, that's doing all the wine configuration part. That's making sure wine is actually set up to make the games, to make the software actually function. And whilst the Bottles that people know today is squarely a GNOME application, it is GTK, it is LibidWader, it is made for the GNOME desktop and nothing else, and this was never going to go away for anyone who liked it, it was always going to be an option. It was not going to be the primary thing that Bottles Next was pushing. Initially, they were looking at doing Electron and Vue.js 3. Now, I am not the biggest fan of Electron. I don't like that everything is becoming a web app. I get why it's happening. It's convenient. It's cheap. You build a web app, you build a native app, you use the same code. It makes sense why you'd want to do it. Also, I am not a fan of LibidWader, because it actively is the worst looking toolkit on everything except for GNOME. It is always massively out of place. This encouragement for using client-side decorations and these hamburger menus where you jam everything into the bar, and then if you hide the bar, the application is broken. So you have to use this bar that doesn't look like any of the other bars on your system. Also, there are these rounded corners, which are a nightmare to remove, and on some desktops, cannot be removed. And there's a whole manner of other set of issues, like the way the cursor works, where on desktops like KDE, you might end up with a cursor that is not the right size, and trying to fix it is a nightmare. So if you ask me whether I like Electron with its much heavier resources or Libidwaiter more, I'm gonna go with Electron 100% of the time. But of course, not everyone shares my viewpoint, and a lot of people just don't like Electron. It doesn't matter what the alternative is, Electron is just bad. And I get that as well. And more recently, this was actually commented on by the Bottles developer. Bottles Next, a matter of technology, published on the 22nd of December. More than a year ago, we announced the beginning of the development of Bottles Next, a project aimed at solving a large number of architectural problems in Bottles source code, issues that to date have prevented the implementation of new features without significant complications. Although we've received a good response to the Bottles Next announcement, it is undeniable that the announcement of using Electron left a sour taste. Among the most common phrases were, another web-based software, my RAM can't handle it anymore, it was better native. I'm sure you have plenty of leftover RAM, there's just a lot of people that don't like RAM number being too high. Anytime you speak, even if you don't speak, you will get some negativity. What is important is whether you deem what's being said as actually useful to listen to. And the developer here actually did. RFW, VNT, and Flutter. Over the past few months, I, Mirko, together with Luca DeMaio, creator of DistroBox, not involved in Bottles development, but they are very good friends and tend to help each other out quite a bit, have tested numerous technologies among libraries, toolkits, and web engines to summarize in a decidedly non-exhaustive list quite a lot of things. Some of which you've probably heard of, like Electron, React.js, Vue.js, Flutter. I would be very surprised if you hadn't heard of GTK and Qt. Same with Iced. Some of the other ones, though, like Fine and Wales and FLTK and Ebit Engine, you may not have heard of. In all of these, we identify challenges and limitations that over time would pose a risk to the project. Among the lack of support for Wayland, hostility in the use of APIs, projects in constant change, lack of features like CSD, that is client-side decorations. As I commented, I am not a fan of client-side decorations. I feel like in most cases they make an application actively worse unless you're using the desktop it is specifically designed for, but that's neither here nor there, etc. We decided to narrow the circle down to two possible groups and identified two possible paths. For the web, Towery or Wales with VNT or RFW, and native with Flutter or RFW. Now, whilst you may have heard of some of these, VNT and RFW, 99% chance you have no idea what it is, because these are toolkits made by the developer of Bottles. VNT is a graphical toolkit developed in Vue.js 3, so it requires a browser to function. The focus is on native feedback of elements, therefore a developer coming from GTK should feel comfortable both in managing graphical components and in design. As for RFW, that is another experimental project at a lower level. It is a reactive framework developed in Go. The purpose of RFW is to allow the creation of both native and web-based apps. So as of a few days ago, this was the direction they were going. This post was made on December 22nd. There has been another shift in direction. Rust and libcosmic in Bottles Next. I don't know what it is about the end of 2024, but I guess everybody right now wants to do big Rust rewrites. So yeah, if you've not seen it, I don't know if it's going up yet. I don't know which order these are going to go up, but the Fish Project is also doing a Rust rewrite as well. Now the Rust part came first, libcosmic a little bit later. The Rust part was announced in this post over on Mastodon. I know this will be like a boomerang, but what do you think if I use Rust instead of Go in Bottles Next? Rust is a highly performant and robust language with a growing community. To be honest, it wasn't my first choice. I would have been more comfortable sticking with Go, but unfortunately, there are no quality GUI toolkits for Go that align with our goals. That's why he was literally building a toolkit to make that happen. As for the libcosmic part, this came from a response from Eduardo Flores, who will constantly see committing things like Smithy, libcosmic, the cosmic desktop, and Rust in general. Have you considered libcosmic? It's based on Iced, and although it's still in development, there are plenty of projects being developed with it. And Mirko wasn't initially convinced, but they had quite a few back and forth comments and eventually moved on to discussing over in a Discord channel and just talking it out just to see if Libcosmic actually makes more sense. Along with that though, the fidelity is made possible thanks to Libcosmic, a modern graphical toolkit based on ICE, developed by System76, the company behind the Cosmic Desktop and PopOS. Their well-known commitment and quality gave us confidence in using Libcosmic. Special thanks to Ed Flores, I don't know how to pronounce his username, this is Eduardo Flores, for creating an early and purely illustrative demo showcasing how Libcosmic could achieve the desired result. You can find the original mock-up here and a demo here. If you would like to go and mess around with the Figma, I will leave this linked in the description down below. And then there's the part that was never going to change. Finally, C# and .NET are almost a necessity since WineBridge is a service application that must run inside the Wine prefix and interact with Windows APIs as seamlessly as possible. What better way than using Microsoft's own language and framework? This part was never up for debate. The Wine agent was always going to be written like this because it just makes the most sense. Now again, for those GTK and Libidwaiter enjoyers, yes, yes, a GTK client will be available for those who prefer it. We are aware that many users appreciate the current Bottles interface and would like to keep it. Don't worry, we won't leave you behind. Now, whilst he says that here, it honestly feels like he's kind of apprehensively keeping GTK around. Looking at some of the replies that he has here about GTK, where is one of them? This is regarding using GTK 4 through GTK RS. I simply do not enjoy how it looks, I do not care about the expectations of the community behind Libidwaiter, and I feel GTK is too restrictive for the UI I want to achieve. That's all. Along with this down here, GTK is a nope from me, the others are interesting. The others being Slint and Iced. I don't think I've spoken to Mirko about his opinion on GTK and Libidwaiter. Considering the project was built with GTK and Libidwaiter, I had assumed that he was a fan of it. Maybe not, and maybe he feels like it's a problem that that's how the application has been built. Now, whilst the Rust language has been around for a while, Rust GUI development, and especially Libcosmic, are still quite young. There are quite a few projects being built with it, but the Cosmic Desktop, where Libcosmic is actually from, is literally still in alpha. So there's not that much that has been done with it, there's not much in the way of documentation, and it might be a bit of a challenge to do so. But besides the Cosmic Desktop, Bottles having a Rust GUI, this would be the next biggest project built with Libcosmic. But what do you think? Do you like Libidwaiter? Do you like Electron? Do you think building it with Libcosmic makes any sense whatsoever? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LiberaPay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I'm going to send you to space.